Paleoanthropological findings do not consist only of bones and artifacts. Sometimes, the presence of early hominids is evidenced by almost intangible but equally significant traces. Such is the case with the Laetoli tracks, footprints perfectly preserved in solidified tuff formed from the ashes of an ancient volcano. What are these footprints found in Laetoli in Tanzania, about 45 kilometers south of Olduvai, one of Africa's most important archaeological sites, tell us? Well, first, they connect us with the other great mystery, that of Lucy, the small female Australopithecus who lived 400,000 years after the Laetoli individuals. And then perhaps they tell us something about the organization of early human family units, which apparently were based on polygamy, such as in use today among our gorilla cousins. One amazing discovery after another. And those who want to know more, follow me. After all, we are talking about the origin of our species. Imagine you're in a remote location that Tanzanians today call Laetoli. The volcano, not too far away, called Sadaman, has just erupted. Yet another thick cloud of carbonatite ash, a beach-like substance with very fine sand. A thin layer, a little more than an inch thick, is left on the ground. Then rains fall. The ash soaks into the water, forming like a fresh cement mash. Creatures living nearby begin to move around and imprint their footprints on this layer of ash. Elephants, giraffes, antelopes, pigs, hares, ostriches, birds, insects, and human creatures. The ash layer soon hardens in the sun, and before it rains again, another eruption, and another in quick succession, perhaps a little over a month. The thickness reaches 20 centimeters. 20 centimeters of volcanic dust at the mercy of the wind, but also fertile ground for the growth, in due time, of the first lichens. Silence fell over the region after the volcanoes thundered for the last time. And the silence lasted for 3.6 million years, until a certain day in 1976, when the famous British paleontologist Mary Leakey, who had been active for decades in Africa in search of the dawn of humanity, decided to organize an expedition to Laetoli, where several years earlier her husband Lewis, also very famous in the field, had carried out some excavations. There it happened that the group of researchers, bored by so much sun and very little fun, took to throwing elephant dung pellets at each other one day. At one point, a young member of the expedition named Andrew Hill, while trying to pick up more ammunition on the ground, noticed strange hollows in the dry bed of a creek. When Hill stopped to examine them, he concluded that they were probably animal footprints. And that diagnosis was confirmed when he went on to examine a larger area where similar footprints were found. No serious effort was made to follow up on this remarkable discovery until the following year, when Mary Leakey's son, Philip, and a colleague, Peter Jones, found in the same place many elephant tracks mixed in with others. These, however, seemed to look suspiciously like human footprints. At this point, Mary Leakey broke the news to the world, exaggerating perhaps and playing with fantasy. She even spoke of early humans traveling to a hypothetical water well and frightened animals fleeing in the face of the looming danger of the erupting volcano. Some anthropologists laughed under their breath, blaming too much sunshine over her many African years for Leakey's wacky hypothesis. Exasperated by her colleague's skepticism, Mary said she was ready to leave Laetoli to its fate. But someone begged her to give it one last chance to prove her point. Reluctantly, Mary agreed, but she was so sure that there was nothing more to be found that she entrusted the search for more tracks to Ndibo, a less experienced local assigned to clean the base camp. Ndibo set to work, trying to emulate the digging methods of the professors. He returned the next day, all jubilant, and said to Leakey, "Come and see, Mama Mary. I found two footprints, a big one and a small one." Although she thought it was a joke, Mary went to have a look and was wide-eyed at what she saw. The footprints really existed, and they were heading north, eventually getting lost under a tangle of vegetation. The group rushed with renewed enthusiasm to the cleanup work. Footprint after footprint was discovered with painstaking patience. They cleared a long piece of ground where eventually more than 50 paired footprints appeared. One small one and one very large one that continued for about 23 meters. Everything was perfectly visible, with typical human morphological features. Indeed, one could detect the modern heel, the perfectly formed plantar arch, and the alignment of the big toe with the other toes, unlike anthropomorphic apes who have the divergent big toe of the prehensile foot. Then the footprints, two easily distinguishable tracks of two individuals of different size, could be noted walking side by side. The larger ones belonged to an adult male, the smaller ones to a female of more petite build. But that's not all. Other, even smaller footprints could be brought out, probably belonging to a cub walking, almost hopping, putting its little feet in the footprints of the larger male. One can speculate that it was a prehistoric family consisting of a father, mother, and child continuing their march through hostile and dangerous territory. But this was a casual advance. The interval between the footprints indicates the width of a normal stride. The little family moved unhurriedly, probably in search of food and water, while on the horizon the volcano rumbled, emitting occasional puffs of ash. Could it be that the taller one was a male and the other a female? Wondered Mary Leakey to herself. Or was it an adult and a teenager? I don't think we'll ever be able to find out for sure. But in one of these fossilized gestures, Mary seemed to glimpse a moment of uncertainty. At some point, in fact, the lower hominid had to be stopped and turned to the left to check perhaps for incoming danger or who knows what else, Mary speculated in an interview. She concluded by saying, clearly moved, that movement, so fully human, is beyond time. However, whatever we might imagine about these beings' intent on crossing the savannah, from their footprints one thing appeared perfectly clear. They walked upright and faced their world standing comfortably on 2 feet. There was finally enough there to confront academia, to say that it was all true that upright stationed hominids walked in that place 3.6 million years earlier, leaving us with the memory of their passage. And the dating was not speculation. It came from the examination of volcanic tuffs made by the potassium-argon method. But who were these individuals? And what species did they belong to? Just 2 years earlier, in 1974, American Don Johansson, another famous paleontologist, had partially answered this question by discovering Lucy, the fossil that later became the world's best known and most popular. Could the beings that had left the Laetoli footprints have been similar to Lucy? Hadar and Laetoli are more than 1,500 kilometers apart, and the footprints in question were 400,000 years older than those imprinted by Hadar hominids. Yet the similarities are such that in 1978, Don Johansson and a colleague, Tim White, christened a new species, Australopithecus afarensis, which included all the fossils from both Hadar and Laetoli. With slight differentiations, probably due to the 400,000 years that separated them, afarensis inhabited the entire Horn of Africa region, down to territories far to the south, such as Tanzania. Okay, if you liked this video, it means that you too are fascinated by the lost world of our origin. And in that case, you should know that we have made many more videos like these. Like, for example, the next video, which will be dedicated to the life and death of Lucy, the mother of us all. An additional novelty is that 40 years after the first footprints were found, about 100 meters away, others were found that seemed to completely change the meaning of the picture. In fact, among so many marks left by animals, the footprints of two other hominids can be also recognized. One is of considerable size, so much so that scholars have renamed it Chewie after the Wookiee from Star Wars. Estimating it to be 1.65 meters tall and weighing 100 pounds, making it the largest known specimen of afarensis. Such a size discrepancy suggests that males and females of Lucy's species had very different physical structures. The phenomenon is called sexual dimorphism, and it allows for the hypothesis of a polygamous reproductive strategy. Dominant males must have had many mates, as is the case among modern gorillas. Taken together, we are looking at a unit consisting of one male, two or three females, and one or two young. That is if the scenario does not get more complicated as the excavations continue. Certainly food for thought. Those footprints of the past confirming the early advent of bipedalism now lift the veil on the social organization of a species that has been extinct for millions of years. But the footprints are also powerful symbolically. No wonder some have compared the Laetoli footprints to Neil Armstrong's made on the lunar surface. One represents humanity's first steps into the cosmos. The other, the evolutionary journey of man since the dawn of time.